students, this video gives you a 5-step practice strategy to implement smooth bowing in your music and to prepare your bowing for more advanced techniques. You might have watched my funny fitness video that gives you 8 perfect exercises for smooth bowing. You can watch it right here. But then you might have done them and think, yeah, Slata, it works when I do the exercise, but then I go play a piece and then my bowing is all stiff again and I don't feel free and the music in my head just doesn't come out of my violin. Well, then take these 5 steps. First of all, it's really important to be a good teacher for yourself. And we are all self-learning. Because if you have a private teacher and you have weekly lessons, then all the other days of the weeks, all the hours that you practice, you're self-learning too. And maybe you are not in the position that you can afford or take private lessons. So for example, if you are doing these exercises like this and this and it goes well and then you move to the frog and instantly you got a stiff hold or maybe a knuckle is locking or whatever happens, then correct yourself instantly because we all think practice makes perfect. Well, practice makes permanent. So if you practice the wrong thing, that's what you tell your hand to do all the time. And the more you do it, the harder it will be to change it. And so if you move to the frog, for example, in these exercises that I explained in the warm-up, and it becomes stiff, then, then instantly go back. Take care of quality, that you're doing the right movement. Also, when you do the thing where you move the bow in the air and it's all getting stiff, then that's what will happen when you are bowing. So instead of that, maybe just try to do it on an open string or in a scale. And then when you can do it comfortably in the middle of the bow, then you can move to longer bow strokes, which is more difficult because you have to keep the bow straight and the movement is more exaggerated in a way. So step 0 was to be a good teacher. First step was to do exercises apart from your violin. And then the second step is to apply them while bowing, but do that on open strings. Now the third step would be to apply it in slow scales. Again, correct yourself all the time and repeat a note if you are not happy with the sound or the bowing that you're using. So if you've got something happening there, then just repeat it, get it right. Don't move through the scale thinking, yeah, finish my skill, I did good for my practice session. No, it's way better if you spend like half an hour with a simple scale than that you just play through it mindlessly, because mindless practice doesn't count for your practice hours. Now, when you have applied it in a slow scale, then you might pick up an etude. And a lot of people don't really know the purpose of etudes. But etudes really bridge the gap between the new techniques that you learn and your pieces, because you've probably experienced a number of times that you learned a new technique successfully, maybe learned a good vibrato or smooth bowing like we learn here, and then you apply it in like this top level piece that's really stretched for you and then suddenly nothing works. So etudes are there to apply your techniques in a musical context. And for new techniques, you really should take an etude that is easy for you. For example, you can do a Wolfhard etude like we do in my free beginner course. I'll link to that right here if you're interested in that. And the Suzuki violin method, for example, that's really popular in America. Here in Europe, it's not really common actually. It has some ups and some downs to it. And one of the good things about the Suzuki method is that they use like Twinkle Twinkle Little Star or something, and they keep getting back to these easy pieces even if they are in book 7 or whatever, and then they use those simple things they know by heart to implement new techniques. And if you are learning according to maybe a European traditional method like I teach and am taught in, then you can do the same thing. You can just grab those old Wolfhard etudes and then play them really slowly. For instance, just take etude number 1. Thank you. and focus here on that movement in your wrist and fingers, on that smooth bowing with a consistent contact point, not moving all over the string, with a straight bow. Maybe several bow strokes per note in the beginning. And slowly move to playing this etude in good tempo. But still be your own teacher and instantly go back in tempo or play several bow strokes per note if you notice that you are not implementing that smooth bowing anymore. Okay, now after that you can go to more advanced etudes, maybe related to the piece that you play, whatever is on your level currently. Now step 5 is to apply it in the repertoire that you are playing right now. When you're practicing, I always recommend to have 3 types of repertoire. Very easy pieces, stuff on your level, stuff that's a stretch. Okay, now you might want to start with the easy pieces to implement a new technique and then, you know, move it up. Because the more difficult pieces will demand more from your focus. So let's say for an easy piece you need 20% focus on that piece, so you still have 80% to focus on that smooth bowing. So if that isn't automated yet, you can still correct yourself a little bit. But if you have that really challenging piece, then, you know, your focus is maybe 90% on the piece. And then your smooth bowing really has to go automatically. And it only goes automatically and fluent if you've really taken these steps, taken your time. This can take months to implement and to really apply to a piece that is a stretch for you. So don't skip these steps and be a good teacher for yourself all the time and hit the brake and go back when needed. Because these steps might seem like a long journey. Just to repeat them, step 0 was to be your own teacher. Step 1, to learn the technique separately of the violin. Step 2 was to apply it on open strings. Step 3 was to apply it in scales. 4 in etudes. 5 in pieces of those 3 different levels. This is the fastest and shortest way in which you can implement a new technique. And I know a lot of students want to go right to that stretch piece. They have the dream piece. It's really good that you have that and that you're practicing that. But that's not the place to start implementing or even learn new techniques. And then you are struggling with the same thing all the time. So really break that cycle and take these steps. So just try it out and let me know in the comments what the results are. If you like my style of teaching, then I'd love to be your teacher. Subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications. I post a new violin lesson at least every week and I already have hundreds of them on my channel for different levels of players. Thanks so much for watching. Hope to see you next time. Bye bye.